Definitely some pretty big snowflakes. And that sidewalk down there is so hard to see. It's just pretty wild design, considering all that's like a drainage ditch there in the corner. Like if you can see through that darkest bush, I have to walk over there sometime. Like I could easily fit my car down in there, and the roof would probably be even with the street. So it's like one of the five homeless people, that truck. Looks like the 18-wheelers, they've all took off. It's not too cold. It's about the right size of the average flake. I mean, it's like about silver dollar size. I had no idea what that machine is. It looks like a wood chipper. It's designed to spit it out into drums. Oh, that's freaking cool. Looks like I gotta get a new battery. It's not like an external battery that you can disconnect. So it's still got quite a few times that it should be able to go to empty and then restart. I'm assuming that's what the cycle count is. Terminal voltage is too high, so definitely go with the new charger and see if that resolves it. The utility box looks pretty well lined up with the gas line. So there should be gas poles out here somewhere flagging where that is. assuming it goes over there to the street and it doesn't stub out and go down where this electrical box is. And I'm thinking just going with some reflective, good reflective duct tape to mark the pole. So if somebody's got a headlamp while they're walking, then they see the flagpole. Because marker paint is kind of expensive. And reflective tape would be useful to mark the ground where a support beam should definitely attach, and that should be protected like it was a fuel pump. So as I look at this more, the reason for the gas lines to be protected with a barrier first is that it looks like two speed bumps would be ideal right here, basically where the signposts are. Looks like somebody's put some thought to map it out before. But I wouldn't suggest doing that before the gas lines got protected, because that is the only spot that stays icy after snow. And then that would help consider better where to put even if it's a FedEx or another alternative mailing company. But if it's just a Dropbox, that doesn't help Ed on getting mail. So it's got to be a receiving and a drop box, and maybe on the island. I mean, ideally, I'm sure UPS or USPS would want it out here on the street edge somewhere in there. I know I've seen before, like 3 years ago, there's a sign for the commercial property laying flat in there. But ultimately, it definitely seems like somebody's invested before in gravel, because that part is still pretty decent. One of the few spots you can walk on without getting mud and tracking it across the drive. But really, if it just had rock on just the drive for going around, like if the 18-wheeler showed up and mail was being dropped or something like that, then they'd have enough room to go by. And then in the future, it still allows the road to be able to drive in this way and park. So the hill would have to get cut back a little bit, pretty much to where the logs are. That would be like a projected curb for parking. And that'd be easily overflow for that side, and then that could leave this open still for trucks and trailers to pull in to some kind of half circle. Probably get maybe two of them in there, and they could still get out. And they got a better exit. It's hard to say long-term what'll actually get developed, whether a different entrance comes up over here on this side, or maybe it's on that side and connects back around into what as an alley between the two properties. I have to look at the property details, but it appears it's pretty much already designed as it's lined out.
Speed posting in it, it's almost like a residential, but it's retail. Retail and commercial, so I guess it's like mixed property. Just the corners are marked off from being no parking. Lindenwood and Akron. And this is a good way out for trucks because it goes into a traffic light after it curves around. Okay, I'm going to drive this again. I thought I got footage before, but I might have accidentally deleted it. This is something PD needs to come over and actually take care of. Ticket the vehicle. Okay, it's clearly marked one way. Truck can get by. If it had a trailer though, it's going to clip him. That'd be his fault, parking in the live lane of traffic. So maybe that's the person that's made the other two calls. I don't know. Apparently he thinks he owns the place too. Prospectors. Better here than in your backyard. Zoom a little closer here and back up and gotta take a look at the hill and see where be. Ideal to plant three trees to basically block off the bad spot. It looks like I could probably drag that out with a hammer pretty easy and yeah, that should work fine there. That allows them to come across the face of it towards this direction. Pretty much where the gravel is right there. Or the between where the gravel's more centered. So I could probably climb that with my car pretty easy and basically create a motorcycle tire track there, and that would be the end of that, so it'd shorten it a little bit. And then that'll stop them from coming over the top and hitting a lower hill, or worse, going into this side over here. So imagine, without talking to security, that it's their concern of putting the camera up to watch it originally. Obviously, I'm giving them more concern. Yeah, that definitely looks like it's going to be a wet night. That's one thing that, another thing that's nice about the old LG1 is that for whatever reason it's a little thinner than that Samsung and it's easier to grab hold of and maneuver. My fingers don't get in the way of the camera. Still working on that, why it rains tonight. A little art project.